Hello and welcome back to XCOM 2 War of the Chosen. My name is Syken and today we're continuing our legendary Ironman no-shot run where we're trying to beat the game on the highest difficulty with zero shots fired and zero grenades or other explosive items used. Yep, you heard it right. That's just melee madness and maybe a couple of psionic abilities once we get Psy Squad. Today we're trying to free Dr. Eva Gomez, a scientist. And moderate difficulty is 3 packs at least, so we're looking at 9 to 12 enemies. Certainly doesn't help that we have a few of our soldiers currently on a covert ops mission, but that's the very nature of the start of the game. You're never having enough people. Who at Firaxis came to the conclusion that having shorts as a normal standard type of legs is acceptable. I mean, look at that. I get it, it's anarchy. But you wouldn't wear any of these except the longer legs. Wow. Whatever. Okay, as I was saying, we are going to join today with 2 Rangers, 1 Templar, and matter of fact even 3 specialists. That's an interesting setup for the group, to say the least. Roby here takes another medkit and Zookugor really just has his 8 protocol. Okay, well, this is going to be a tough mission. I am fully expecting us to take some damage and we're lacking offense, so I am happy that I made quick feed yet another ranger, but even with him as a ranger we're still lacking offense. We definitely need an upgrade for the swords, we need an upgrade for the armor, we need better vests, and we need more armor overall. We need to be more beefy in order to go through this. But enough complaining, let's jump into the action. We landed. Wow, it's a large map. That's usually what you do. Oh, wow, that is a large map. That's usually what you do not want to have if you're trying to go in with an all melee squad. Okay, it's getting better by the minute. That is also something that you rather do not want to have. Luckily, we do have enemy protocol, which will give us at least some damage against the turret. Turrets is the correct description. All right, let's buckle up and just rush as far as we can. Yeah, and Zookugor with his 8 protocol really, yeah, doesn't do much other than giving 8 protocol, right? Right. A lot of armor. Those guys are tough as nails. Starting with Roby. Starting with being spotted, of course. Nice little hit. I can see we triggered something. Ooh, not good. Not good at all. Okay, we don't want to be on the rooftop. Not when we're going to fight this guy. Okay, so teamwork in over here. We will need to finish the towers first. Okay, a tiny bit of focus, that is good. We could theoretically drop down, fair enough. I'm seriously considering if we would want them to charge into us, which is probably the better plan, really. Enemy protocol with this guy would certainly make sense. So how about we're doing a couple of things. Number one, I'd like to know what we're dealing with. Are there more enemies? We already see there's another pack here. But there are not more enemies. We definitely need to let them come into us. If we're now charging in, these guys will add, and it's pretty much GG. So we're using our concealment ability. And we're going to hunker down. Hawkbite gets the 8 protocol. Good. Quick Feet moves up, then begins to conceal himself and hunker down. Just out of curiosity, probably could move all the way up to here. Yeah, that saves some time. He won't be spotted out. Okay, so, almost inclined to just drop down and use the enemy protocol, common protocol, sorry, but, I don't want to put Sonar in a difficult spot here. Common protocol ends his turn. Only hit the sector, we don't want that. Might as well conceal. And move all the way up to here. Okay, cool. Roby has taken his turn. Thank you. And Hawkbite likewise has taken his turn. Thank you. So both of them are fine. Going to hunker down. And that forces the enemy to fully move into us. Well, that was a smart move. And that is pretty much a double move until they reveal this. Okay, cool. Right, moving all the way up to here. Three points of damage to go. Gotta hit that Advent mech, and we gotta hit it really well. It has put itself nicely kind of behind here so that we can't reach it. Ah. Let's kill this guy first. Very nice.
Enemy destroyed.
Good. Combat protocol. How do we want to deal with that? Charging in. Not enough damage to kill it. Just the whole problem. Late Storm would be good for another hit, but not to kill it, which is actually the main issue that we're running into. Can't seem to find a good position. Maybe here. Yeah, that one is good. That one is good. Spotted it out. But that also means we're giving it a good old combat protocol. 4 to 5 points of damage. Ignoring the armor. Obi gets an 8 protocol just in case the sectoid decides to take a shot. Still 5 more turns. We're okay. Although, it's getting closer. And lucky us, we used 8 protocol. There's the Blade Storm. And there is the additional pack. More action music appears as we can't seem to catch a break. Let's see if this here is going to kill him in one go. Nope, 50-50, just barely misses him. Got him. Very good. But the tower in itself currently isn't the problem. Nice, that was a very clean one shot. Got two more enemies in there. And we're going to use abuse some vision right here. Templar moves in. We're going to move to the door. We're just going to close the door. And yep, see you later, alligator. Still being completely concealed. Another concealment over here. So we got scouts on the left and on the right. Oh, what? Okay, interesting. Very interesting. Cool. Well, I think Roby had a medkit himself, if I'm not mistaken. Yep, we could theoretically use it. The biggest problem currently is that tower here. Someone's got to trigger it. And the way that I'm seeing it, that someone's probably going to be hogbite. Can we reach anyone over here? No, we can't. Can we reach anyone over? No, we can't. Hmm. Okay. That is unfortunate. Opening the door. Hogbite is charging in. That might result in a hit. Yep. His Bladestorm will make short process with both of them. Now, medical heal, yes. And let's move up. All right, moving up as well. Nope, we don't want to use medical protocol. We don't want to use combat protocol. We very much want to use medical protocol on Hogbite. Obi gets an 8 protocol just in case the tower can see him again. I don't want to cause any more drama here. Scouting just a tiny bit further, eventually getting to hack the actual target soon. Oh boy, Bladestorm would be so incredibly valuable here. Hogbite is just dominating. The legend back in business. That is what brought him the status of a legend. Moving to stun the stun lancer. Okay, so we're down to 1 HP. Could have taken him from the other side. Can move up to kill the tower. We unfortunately can't kill them all.
No longer a threat. Moving out.
Very well, that's a hit, and we're just going to move up here, and that's the kill for the tower. Now, the only remaining problem is this guy over here. And I don't want to miss the mission.
Objective located.
So we're moving in instead of using aid protocol. There's really not much we can do here, just hunkering down. There's potentially one shot against Roby. We got the tower down, which was annoying. That's okay. It'll send both of them to the sick bay, but none of them got severely hurt. Hacking the workstation? Yes, please. Alright, Zoo Cougar. Income plus 25 isn't bad at all. This year will just give us three more days or two more days. We currently don't have anything big. But yeah, 25 isn't bad. It's actually quite respectable. Alright, Roby. Let's kill that officer. Yep, show him who's boss. Exactly.
Okay. Digging in.
Okay, we still got concealment here, so might as well use that to our advantage. At the same time, we're moving back. Yeah, and let's heal Roby. Hawkbite can take a conceal himself and essentially be the one-man army that is going to scout out where the enemy is located.
Heading out. The march continues.
The good news about him being here is, with a blade storm, this here might be a 3-for-1. Well, let's see how well Hawkbite is doing this. Either this is going to be the move of the mission, or it's going to be a pretty dumb move. Let's see. All right. That's 1-0. He's a quick looter. That's 2-0. 3-0. But he took damage. And that's why it was the move of the mission, but also stupid because he took damage. It was still worth it for shits and giggles. We would have taken damage either way. Let's be clear, we currently have no counterplay to that. We will have counterplay later. Okay, we're back in action, and 12 dice for Hogbite. That is acceptable. A lot of people here are incredibly tired. No real connection with anyone. Wow, still not a single connection, guys. Sane Elliot, let's go for combat protocol. We just need more offensive tools at this point. And yeah, I mean, overall successful mission.
Hello, Commander.
We countered a horrible, horrible dark event, and we got ourselves a scientist. So that's not too bad. In terms of training, Sane, we're lacking the points, but medical protocol would be fantastic for him as well. Good. And after that nice little rumble, we probably... Rookies, well, that wouldn't be bad. That's worth between 80 and 120 supplies. But we gotta heal. We currently can't field a proper team. And that is unacceptable. The Alois are incredibly important for us. So a few things here. Excavation, yes please. Yes please, start excavating. Empty this one here. Fill it up here. Thank you, because this is going to give us energy. In terms of... Can't really build anything other than a power relay. I really thought that the resistance ring was only 2 energy. Shame on me that I misremembered that. Don't want to go for a power relay though. I would really like to use that exposed power coil here and just do a fast push. That's another month. But we would get quite a few items freed up in the meantime. Can we get power from somewhere else? Probably not, unless it spawns on the map. What we can do though is build items and... Oh, this is not enough, but we got 15 and 10. Yeah. Perfect. Weapons are upgraded. That was important, very important. Could get another mind shield if needed. But yeah, next up, let's get some more alloys. 60 alloys would be nice. Getting... both of that here cleared up is helpful. The colonies, but they'd have to be producing it from something here on Earth. They seem to have an endless supply of this stuff. We've got the schematics and our equipment. In terms of options here, Schooljack definitely would be one of the things that I'd be looking forward to. Gives us a kill option. Short visit to the black market really quick so that we can start the school check. That way the proving grounds are also not idle. I want to make sure that the build order makes sense. Scope is not needed. We can get rid of it. Advanced expanded magazine for 44. Fantastic. Probably okay to sell two of the Alarium cores. I wouldn't see why we need that many. Few stun mounts of corpses are good as well. Yeah, and I think money-wise we're okay. Yeah, we don't need any of that. We might need some Alarum crystals later down the line for our psionic endeavors.
Commander, the factions have indicated they know how to track down the Chosen. We should construct the ring facility so they have a place to coordinate.
Yeah, I do agree. Give me power, I'll do it.
If you want to know the truth about the Templars, I suspect they all might be...
Let's think. I mean, yes. Resistance ring needed, definitely. Infirmary would be plentiful, important. Resistance comms would also be not unimportant. So I am wondering if we're losing too much momentum, if I'm now trying to be too stingy and go for the power coil here. So probably we would, and that's what I'm concerned about. There's really nothing. We're not losing that much by building the power relay here. Before we clean this one, it'll be some time. And, you know, I mean, honestly speaking, we can probably still demolish this and then start reutilizing the space without much delay.
Power relay construction initiated.
But yeah, having that here helps. Then we can build the resistance comms probably. So that we can expand a bit further. I would say contacts are important and the resistance ring. Either of those will be the next building. The infirmary would make sense because it frees up time that we can scan more freely. School check 20 days definitely makes sense. That's good. We're making progress with a very core storyline and also giving us skill options. Back to definitely the only thing that we should do at this point, which is making sure that we have a full team available. And given that we are taking a lot of damage, the infirmary might also be helpful. Advent carries more explosives. I couldn't care less. Really, I mean, that's compared to the others, not even worth mentioning. We got a couple of days wounded. Yeah. We're just seeing that everyone is wounded for just very, very long time. Good, mobility has increased plus one, and we finally found our last faction hero.
Skirmisher faction. They may look like Advent, but they sure don't act like it. Now that we've established contact, we can...
The Skirmisher is an interesting class because normally you would guess, you know what, they can only, like, their shtick is to shoot twice. And you could think that, but in reality, if you look at the tree, they have Bladestorm as a built-in feature. They can pull enemies towards us. They can pull themselves towards enemies. They can shift their action units to someone else. So with the right cooldown reduction build, I could see that they will actually add quite a bit of value to the team. Yeah, the only problem is we need to level them and eventually, first of all, get there. Good. Monthly income decreased by 22, which is pretty much a substantial decrease, but we got a 25 increase beforehand, so we're still fine.
The Chosen are gonna do whatever it takes to get to you, Commander, even if that means wiping out entire camps.
Pretty slow month overall, but that's okay, I can live with it. A option for a supply rate would be fine. Wonderful. We just got that. Advent has Advent only leadership. And Hogbite just recovered in time. That couldn't have been scripted better. So we can even take Sane onto this mission. Hogbite, Divat, Quick Feet. That's 3. Skirmisher 4. Skirmisher will not deal damage, though. Hmm. And Sonar plus Sane. Or Sonar plus Sukuger, because Sane is still tired and I don't want another Shaken Soldier, so Sukuger. That sounds like a decent team, I suppose. I would probably prefer having another Ranger with us, but it is what it is. We just got the upgrades to our weapons, so we should be in tip-top shape. We're ready to go with Psionics as well, which means if this year is built and this year is cleared, you could even go as far as to say, you know what, we're starting with Psionics relatively soon. It would come as an opportunity cost. Psionics are super power hungry. Yeah, they take a long time to build on top of it, but yeah, I could adjust the build order and go to Psionics into resistance ring, but we're still low on contacts. On the other hand, if we look at the map, the only reason why you want to have contacts besides increasing your income is you want to be able to counter certain events. Currently, we're not having the intel to do that. We're going to get some at the supply rate now, but we want to get the intel and essentially start making contact here, and then go and get the access to the facility there. From an avatar project, we're still fine. Lakeside facility is also still available, so we do have a couple of tools to fight back the avatar progress. Nonetheless, the more intelligent build order probably would be something along the lines of building the power relay here, then going into the resistance communication, because that will fully take care of the contacts, and then going into Psionics with the shielded power coil, digging through all of this, building another energy core here, so that this will power our entire base, and then ramping this one down, getting either an infirmary or resistance ring up, and vice versa, the other one here. Probably resistance ring soon. I feel that the proving ground was a nice idea at the beginning. For the Skulljack, definitely good. When we have more resources, I think that exosuits, spider suits might also be a good option. They increase dodge, they increase movement, they give you the hook ability, which if you put that together with a lot of the Rangers, that can be quite powerful. So that is helpful. And we can build the axe here, which is a wonderful melee weapon. So yeah, I'm not disappointed about GTS into Proving Ground. You could go GTS into Resistance Ring into Proving Ground. Training Center definitely had its upsides, because we we needed it in this build here for the specialists right away to kind of get the healing protocol and the combat protocol. And now that we're going further to also continue having to take them from both of the trees, they are very, very ability point hungry. And if they need to only deal their damage through combat protocol and cannot use their weapons, it essentially forces us to use training center a bit earlier. So I'm not opposed to that structure. The downside of the build order that I've chosen is, of course, it's now very difficult to also gem the Psy Rush in here. And maybe we're going to find ourselves just dealing with a melee run for now and essentially going power relay into resistance contacts, into resistance ring, then shielded power coil, kind of doing all of the movements here, and starting to build the Psy Lab here, de-build this, and do the second Psy Lab here, and then down here, infirmary, then, ooh, can we even take defense turrets? No, we can't, because they are guns, so you wouldn't want to shoot. Well, that just freed up a slot, I suppose. Yeah, okay, so final build is probably two times energy here and here, then two times the psionic chambers. We're going to have infirmary, shadow chamber, and whatever else I feel like down here. And yep, that is it from a building perspective. That brings us to the end of today's episode. If you like what you've seen, feel free to leave a comment and a like down below. That always helps the videos. And see you, of course, in our next run. Take care. Bye-bye.